Colourful Romsey is a film miscellany of scenes taken around 1948 to about 1952. This is evident, of course, from the fact that at one point German prisoners of war may be seen walking along the Hundred. The music for the film has been specially recorded in Romsey Abbey, and the organist is George Goulding. A.E. Turner presents Colourful Romsey, and there's the marketplace with the Romsey Working Men's Conservative Club in the background, and there's one of the green Hanson Dorset buses waiting to go to Southampton, just 1 and 6 pence return. And here a view of Romsey Abbey. And houses down by Abbey Meads. And that was Stanley Vane's Parrot, with the background of the Abbey. And that's on the way down to the War Memorial Park, just over the bridge. And in the Hundred, there's Timothy White's, which is now Boots the Chemist's, and Pearson Sons, the Baker's, and two German prisoners of war just walked across the screen from right to left. That's the original sign that my wife made, which started up the Royal Air Forces Association in Romsey. And there's Latimer Street with FCM Vokes, the newsagent's shop, with the canopy out. Holman's, the greengrocer's. And on the right was Purchase and Sons, the grocers. Now on the right is T. Ely and Sons, the ironmongers, that's on the extreme right. And in the background, of course, once again, Romsey Abbey. Woolworths and the international stores, the groceries store in Romsey. And Hyde and Co., the seed and grain merchants, which is now a hardware house, a green Hanson Dorset bus goes by, and one of Strong & Co.'s brewery lorries, closely followed by a Royal Blue coach. And that was a fish shop that was nearly opposite the present Waitrose supermarket. One of Reed and Malick's little lorries just proceeded from left to right. There's Boots' old shop next to the Conservative Club. Of course, they have now moved to Timothy White's premises, as you saw just now. Weber's restaurant, that was that is now the Palmerston restaurant, and before that it was owned by the Turner family. No connection with myself. There's some Battle of Britain posters. The Cycle Works and Wiggins and Son, that is now a lingerie shop, and the chemist is still a chemist. Lloyd's Bank, Romsey, and you'll see how very, very dirty the front of the building became during World War II. And up on the top you will see the cupola, which eventually became dangerous, and pieces of it started falling down onto the pavement, nearly killing people. And you'll notice, if you look at it nowadays, it looks rather different. S.J. Bourne and Son, the fish merchants, is now Fox and Sons, and this is now the entrance to Broadlands. Church view along by the bypass. That is Blue Mists, Oakley Gardens, Botley Road, which was where I was living earlier on. And now we're going to see some Romsey flowers. And since there's not a great deal I can say about the flowers, they're pretty self-evident, perhaps you'd like to turn up the sound channel of the video and listen to the organ of George Goulding just for a few moments. There is Palmerston House in the background, which was the boys' home. Presided over by Mr. Orton. There is one of our cats. When we were at Blue Mists, that one was called Silver, and that one was called Blackie. Two dearly loved cats. Silver and Blackie, and Silver again. and a Red Admiral butterfly. And there's some bees there on that plant. I'm ashamed to say I don't know the name of it, of the plant. But I'm sure you do. There's some delphiniums anyway. Blue. Nice lovely blue. Some love in the mist. I rather like this shot of the white blossom against the blue sky. And that's a double poppy. Now this is next door but one to us at Blue Miss. You notice the garden is concreted down. That was done by Mr. Hatcher. And the people who followed in the house after them ripped all the concrete up and replaced it with a green lawn. During the war, those chains, which you could see just then, were all taken away. Now here we're in one of A.R. Wills Limited glass houses. A.R. Wills Limited, of course, were mainly suppliers of tomatoes to the south of England and cucumbers, but they also provided pot plants as well, as you'll see here. And there is the late Jimmy Wills, the son of A.R. Wills, tomatoes for vitamins. These were our next door neighbours in Oakley Gardens. Mr. Mrs. Tonkin, T-O-N-K-I-N. There's Mr. Orton, digging for victory. And now some azaleas. That's Bernard Wiggins on the staff at Lloyds Bank Romsey at that time. Here are the silver cups at the Romsey show. This must have been about 1951, I should think. For the first 3 years, Lloyds Bank did the financial business for the show with a taxi. We went round all the gates and threw the money into great big sacks and then sorted it all out later in the evening, about 9 o'clock, back at Lloyds Bank Romsey. J.R. Wood & Co.'s display at the show. There's myself on the left of the picture, the Lloyds Bank caravan. Must have been about 1951, I think. There's Edgar Fry lighting his pipe. That was the first year that we had a caravan up there. There's Douglas Pear, who's still with us, living at Brashfield. Edgar Fry looks at a prospectus, doesn't like it, and shuts it up again. And there is myself leaning on the counter with the RAF Association badge in my lapel. And we have a visitor into the Lloyds Bank caravan. And that is the view through one of the side windows of the caravan. Edgar Fry on the left, Douglas Pear with his pipe on the right. Aspect, the oldest house in Romsey in Palmerston Street, and it's now a restaurant. There's a view of Broadlands taken from the bridge, and there's a view from the other side of the bridge looking at the Test, the River Test. And there's the bridge concerned, and some more of the River Test. Now, that is the rear view of the War Memorial Park, as you might say, the children's swings. And there are some ducks on the test. This building used to be the workhouse when it was known as the Gardens. I believe it is now known as Nightingale Lodge. Here's the Plaza Cinema, which was bought a little while ago by the Romsey Amateur Operatic and Dramatic Society. And here it is at night, with the neon lighting showing, as it was at that time when it was a cinema. All that neon lighting has in fact been stripped off since the Operatic Society took over the Plaza. And now Douglas Fairbanks Jr. crowns the festival queen. Now, this was outside the town hall, and in a moment you'll see the Douglas Fairbanks Jr. stepping up onto the rostrum. There's the Mayor and Mayors go up first, and there's Douglas Fairbanks there between Mr. J.B.S. Attlee and Mrs. Attlee, the Mayor and Mayors of Romsey. That microphone, by the way, which you can see there, was very, very poor. You could hardly hear a word on it. Here's the festival queen coming along with, and at her feet is young Peter Knight, son of Dr. H.B. Knight. I think he's now aged about 40 and farming in the West Country. But he covers himself with glory in just a moment, as you will see. Mr. J.B.S. Attlee addressing. And Douglas Fairbanks Jr. turns on the charm. And here comes young Peter Knight. And whoops-a-daisy, he's on the ground. The crown is picked up, and Douglas Fairbanks Jr. duly places it on the head of the festival queen. This is the bypass before those poplar trees had to be cut down because they became unsafe. What a pity it was, because it really was lovely. And there's the Palmerston Street and the Crossfield Hall. The Horse and Jockey Public House, one of Strong's houses, is now a veterinary surgeon's surgery. Another view of the bypass, which when I first came to Romsey in 1932 just didn't exist. And all the traffic from London to Bournemouth used to go down Bell Street. You would hardly believe it. The Stroud School Sports. There's Douglas Fair and Mrs. Fair. And Vi Pottinger. And that's Vi Pottinger's little girl. And that's Douglas Fair's little girl, as they were then. Probably nearly grandparents by the time I'm speaking now, in December 1987. And here are the sports. And somewhere among all this lot is my own son, but we'd never be able to find him. Mrs. Henry and Miss Butler in the pink. Miss Butler was teaching at the school. There's Mr. Reg Lehman of AR Wills Limited with the red rose in his lapel. Douglas Fair urging on his then young son. And this was the tea party after the sports events. And there in the background is Stroud School. Charter day in Romsey when Her Majesty the Queen came to Romsey, and unfortunately I had the zoom lens had not been invented, and the result is you will only get a glimpse of the Queen. Had I had a zoom lens, I could have done wonders, but I say hadn't been invented. There's the post office in the background, which is now the National Westminster Bank. You can just see Prince Philip there in the background behind the Queen, almost as a silhouette. And the mayor presents something or another to the Queen, but I don't quite know what. He bows to her. And now you can see the Queen there, but over a zoom lens. And the young lady who presented the bouquet to the Queen was, as far as I remember, one of the pupils of La Sagesse Convent. And then at the end, they roasted an ox, just outside what is now Barclays Bank. And so we come to the end.